Here's Fox Sports Midwest Dan McLaughlin with my former teammate Keith Hernandez.
What's it like for Keith Hernandez when he comes back to St. Louis, number one, and then the memories that come flooding in?
Well, it's always great to come back to St. Louis. All my youthful memories are here. This is where I started and where I struggled and where I finally made it to the top and had a World Series championship. So it's always great to be downtown. It's more nostalgic for me when I walk by where Cardinal Nation is now over there and where the old stadium was, and then they're constructing more stuff there, and they're going to kind of bury our old stadium. It's gone for good, you know. A lot of good times out there.
Your book, it's very Cardinal-eccentric. What can you tell us about the book?
It's an autobiography. It doesn't go in chronological order. It goes forward, it goes back, goes present. But mainly it's Cardinal stuff. So we realized when we started writing the book, it took about a 2.5-year process, that if we were to do my whole life up to present, to the booth, it would be 1,000 pages. And then we realized, okay, they wanted it 90,000 words, which is around 330 pages. And how do you condense, you know, my career, my life in 330 pages? So when I felt that I was a major league player, that I belonged on the same field with Pete Rose, Mike Schmidt, Ozzie Smith, Steve Carlton, Seaver, you name them, that I was one of them and a pretty doggone good one. And that would have been after my great April in 1980. Even after my 79 MVP and batting title year, I still went into 80 because I'd had a good year, a bad year, and then a great year with 79. And I remember Rick Hummel wrote a column, we laugh about it to this day, well, will the real Keith Hernandez stand up coming into 1980 season? And I'd always had bad Aprils. I had a 230 April in 79. When I won the batting title. And April was always a bugaboo for me, and I just had, from the get-go, I raked. And when that April was over and I was hitting around three, whatever, high 300s, that's when I realized it was all behind me now, and I had the confidence. I knew that I was a major league player, and that's basically where the book starts. So it's all my youth, being taught my father, high school, Cardinals, heavy, George Kissel, Bob Kennedy, Ken Boyer, but it lets off a little bit before Whitey. Now this kind of opens the door, if this book is very successful, it opens the door for a second book which will deal 80s onward. Well, I think for anybody and any walk of life, it's my struggles with my insecurities. I was my own worst enemy. I didn't believe in myself. I got sent down. I struggled mightily. I was in A-ball. I hit 250 in A-ball. I hit 260 in double A, and I go over that double A year. It was a very emotional year for me, an up and down year. I just hadn't learned to make the transition from playing two games a week in high school and summer ball to playing every day. That's a big getting used to. And plus, I'm hitting 500 in high school. I'm not hitting 500 in the minor leagues. And it can shake your tree a little bit. So it's basically my trials and tribulations, my ups and downs, my insecurities, my fun times, the bus rides in the minor leagues, struggling in 76 and having a great second half, and then my breakout year in 77 and a bad year in 78. So it's all that what got me to the player I became. So I think a lot of people, you know, whether you're a businessman or entrepreneur, you struggle to claw to get to the top. You have your ups and downs. And I think it's very revealing. I think a lot of people will be surprised.